Coming to the result and discussion part, by obtaining the steam distillation method, we'll obtain the clove. As per the biological source, it should give at least 15% VYW of volatile oil. This is the identification of the purity of the clove flower bud. As all of us aware, nowadays these traditional spices has been adulterated with many inferior quality of drugs, but the clove, the genuine clove, should contain at least 15% of VYW of volatile oil. Now, these collected volatile oil, the color of the oil should be a pale yellowish in color. The melting point is around 40 degrees centigrade. It should be insoluble in cold water, whereas soluble in organic solvents like alcohol. As I already mentioned, clove oil is heavier than water, so obviously it should immerse in the water. Coming to the medicinal property, clove is a strong antimicrobial, clove volatile oil is a strong antimicrobial agent. Moreover, it is an antiseptic. It is also used as dental analgesic. In case of toothache problem, the clove oil is used. Other uses include, it is used as carminative, means it helps to expel out the excess of gases from stomach. Then it is also used as GIT stimulant, aromatic and flavoring agent. So these are the medicinal properties of clove oil. Now we have to report in that fashion the percentage yield of the volatile oil from clove flower bud was found to be how much. Suppose we have taken 50 gram of clove flower bud and we obtained around let us imagine 6 ml of volatile oil. So from 50 gram of clove flower bud, 6 ml of volatile oil is obtained. From 100 gram, around 12 ml of volatile oil is obtained. So the percentage yield is 12%. So like that, we have to calculate the percentage yield and we have to report. Moreover, here I wish to mention the main active constituent present in the clove volatile oil is the eugenol and its eugenol acetate. It also contains beta caryophyllene. These two are very potent phytoconstituent as far as clove medicinal uses concern. Now coming to the identification tests for the clove oil. Now we have to prepare the chloroform extract of the clove. To the chloroform extract, drop around 30% aqueous solution of sodium hydroxide saturated with sodium bromide. Wait for some time. After that, the needle and pear-shaped crystals of sodium eugenate will appear in rosette shape. So this crystallization test is one of the identification tests for eugenol. As I mentioned, in the presence of sodium hydroxide, the eugenol present in the clove flower bud will be converted to sodium eugenate, which gives rosette shape crystals. These are the identification tests for clove oil. So overall, what we have learned from this experiment, so this clove oil is extracted from the clove flower bud by using an apparatus called Clevenger apparatus. The principle involved here is hydrosteam distillation method, and by this steam distillation method, we have to collect the volatile oil from clove and we have to calculate the percentage yield. So as far as the standardization concern, the clove oil should contain at least 15% VYW of volatile oil. So which is an indicative of the purity of clove flower bud. So these are various aspects of clove flower bud, isolation of the volatile oil from clove flower bud.